The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. A very warm welcome, and it is a warm welcome, on this very happy occasion for the marriage of Michael and Zara. It's very good to see people here, especially as post-COVID it's all been so difficult, so it's wonderful we've actually all made it here today. So it is a very joyful occasion, but it's also a very solemn occasion. So I would ask you now to switch off your mobile phones and pop them away. Thank you. God is love. And those who live in love live in God. And God lives in them. Let us pray. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you. And you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So we remain standing to sing our opening hymn, Give Me Joy in My Heart.
Thank you. Yeah, all good, you?
Come together to witness the marriage of Michael and Zara, to pray for God's blessing upon them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they should be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Holy Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delights and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. 'Tis given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God, and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating the wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Michael and Zara are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. But first, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. The vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Who brings this woman to be married to this man?
Father.
Michael, will you take Zara to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Zara, will you take Michael to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Let us pray. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Michael and Zara, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now hear our readings, which are given by Jean and Claire.
Reading is taken from Romans. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another. Honour one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervour, serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affection, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with each other.
He's not perfect, by Bob Marley. He's not perfect, you aren't either, and the two of you will never be perfect. But if he can make you laugh at least once, causes you to think twice, and if he admits to being human and making mistakes, hold on to him and give him the most you can. He isn't going to quote poetry, he's not thinking about you every moment, but he will give you a part of him that he knows you could break. Don't hurt him, don't change him, and don't expect for more than he can give. Don't analyse. Smile when he makes you happy, yell when he makes you mad, and miss him when he's not there. Love hard when there is love to be had, because perfect guys don't exist, but there's always one guy that is perfect.
Thanks, Claire. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. When we did the rehearsal on Sunday and I saw the order of service for the first time, I said, well, is that the Gene Reimer? Because I've known Gene for the best part of 20 years, haven't I, Gene, since Copenhagen School. So it's really lovely that she was able to read you today. One of the most famous things the late Diana, Princess of Wales, said was, well, there were three people in this marriage, so it was a bit crowded. The truth is, of course, it takes a lot more than three people to make a marriage. But not like that. As the young people say, hashtag just saying. A marriage, of course, takes a community. A community of family and friends. And this applies even more so to Michael and Zara, because they have invited, by getting married in church, invited God into their marriage. The Christian understanding of marriage, that it is life-giving and lifelong, is very different from the modern secular idea that a marriage is only good whilst it feels good and then should be chucked out like last year's fashions, though of course nobody ever goes into a marriage hoping or expecting it to fail. But that Christian understanding, which can feel restrictive, is in fact quite the reverse, for it gives Michael and Zara the freedom to grow together within the community. For Christianity is a community too. The oldest heresy is, oh, well, you can be a Christian without going to church. No, you can't, because part of being a Christian is to be part of the community. And it is in that community, as well as the community of family and friends, that Michael and Zara will work out their marriage. And it is your and our deep responsibility to nurture, protect, and support them through all the years that lie ahead. So with that in mind, I invite you now to stand to witness the marriage of Zara and Michael.
Right.
Right.
Sorry. I'm Michael.
I'm Michael.
Take you, Zara.
Take you, Zara.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better. For worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
I, Zara.
I, Zara.
Take you, Michael.
Take you, Michael.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, Let these rings be to Michael and Zara symbols of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Zara, I give you this ring.
Zara, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Michael, I give you this ring.
Michael, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
You alright?
Yeah.
Yeah. Make sure I'm not on your dress.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, Michael and Zara have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Blessed are you, O Lord our God. For you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace, and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessings upon Michael and Zara in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. I would now ask the congregation to sit quietly during the signing of the registers whilst the choir sings so beautifully.
My thigh was going to cramp up. I was like, whoa.
faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Zara and Michael to this day, and we pray for them now. May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to neighbours in need and embrace those in distress. May they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives. And may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. May they nurture their family and friends with devotion, see their children grow in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. And so we sum up our prayers as we say together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you and all whom you love and care for this day and always. Amen.
Come on! classic, that one, isn't it?
I have to clean this car.
Right.
No.
Back a little bit. Together.
Thank you. quite proud we are, Zara. She's done all this, and it's not easy with this virus going on. She always sees things, 100% she gives to this. One day she came home and said she wanted to go to Europe. So she booked it up, went down, Houston, got on a coach, didn't know anybody, and off she went around Europe on her own. And then she said, come back, wanted to join the police force. Done the same thing. Joined the police force, passed out. Very proud of this girl. Yeah. You often wondered who she was going to meet when she was growing up. We met him. Yeah. We met him at Wembley, the playoff final. It's QBR and Derby.
Yeah. Yeah, it was. It was.
Yes. Yeah, straight away we knew that was it. Michael was the one. After that, we went back to our pub. There was more football, wasn't it?
Champions League.
So I met all our friends. We ended up having a conversation with my mate, Big John. God bless you, mate. And they were talking about what their favourite meals were after a drink. And I think they both settled on it. Was it all day breakfast?
It was an all day breakfast.
All day breakfast. So you can have it all day.
You can have it all day.
And it just fitted straight in. Everyone loved him. So, yeah, look, all you guys that turned up, you know your mate, Michael. He's a lovely fella, isn't he? And, yeah. Yeah. And that's down to John and Julie. The way they brought them up. They're a lovely family. Nicola, dangerous. Yeah. No, they're good people. And, that's it. Finally, just like to say on behalf of John and Julie, me and Julie, thank you for giving us that little grandson over there. That beautiful boy. And he's got a lovely sense of humour as well. Thank you both for that. You all right, Alf?
Picking his nose, I think.
He's got his hand up his trumpet at the minute.
Even he's laughing.
Anyway, I'll just thank you all again, and I think Mike's gonna. Well, it looks like he's got a phone book here. I'm gonna say a few words. Thank you very much.
I'll have a go. Right, well, we did it. We finally did it. Yeah! Get in there! Right, just a few thank yous from me before I pass you over to Dave for the main event. He's really, really looking forward to it. So, a couple of nights ago, I asked Dave to print my speech out for me. Bit of an error. So I've got a speech here in a small font with every other line being light sky blue that I can't really see. So just bear with me for a minute or two. To Zara, you're looking absolutely incredible today. I should probably say she looks incredible every day, but boring. And there was a bit of a transformation on Wednesday night. She popped out of the house about 6 o'clock, and she's out now. I popped back in, and I thought she'd been for 2 weeks in the Caribbean. It's amazing what you get with a bit of fresh air these days. So Zara, thank you for all the effort in making today so special. As you all know, it hasn't been easy for us. We're on our third wedding date, second ceremony venue, second reception venue. And whilst I was all down in the dumps with the cancellations, Zara just kept plugging on. Whether it was the roof falling in on the church or the videographer emigrating to Australia, she was back and forward to the money tree, making sure that today went ahead. Well done. Well done, Zara. Zara and I actually met 8 years ago today. It was a real fairy tale romance. She even said one of our early dates was better than being at work. Set the bar very high early on. In late 2017, we were blessed with the birth of Arthur. 3 years prior, we were told that we would never likely become a three. And not a day goes by that we aren't eternally thankful for all the sleepless nights, ketchup on the sofa, and Play-Doh wedged into the lounge carpet. We wouldn't have it any other way. There's a present here for you, Arthur. When I've finished talking and David's finished talking, you can come and open it. To the mums and dads, firstly from my side, Mum, Dad, thank you for a lifetime of love, care and support. You're always in my corner, and I hope I've made you proud. My favourite memory has to be breaking my arm at a friend's birthday when I was about 10. It was Mark's birthday, actually. You left me all weekend with a broken arm until Monday morning arrived and you took me to the doctors and a horrified doctor told you it might be best to take me for an x-ray. 6 weeks in a cast. Happy memories. To Alan and Julie, thank you for a lifetime of support you've given to Zara. I'm sure it wasn't easy. Thank you for treating me like one of the family from day one, always being first to the bar and always keeping my pint topped up. I guess the least I could do was take Zara off your hands. To my brother and sister, thank you both for playing such a key role in our special day. Thank you for the stag and the hen do's, for putting up with all the stress and all the cancellations. Thank you to the ushers and the bridesmaids for playing such a key role in our special day. And thank you for helping with all those stag weekends and creating such fantastic memories for us. From my perspective, my friends are like brothers. Some of us have known each other since I was Arthur's age. And it's occasions like this when we should celebrate that. I hope Arthur one day has a group of friends like mine. Thank you to Jeannie for the wonderful cake. And thank you for all the effort in making it so perfect. It looks wonderful. And last but by no means least, thank you to all our guests for joining us today. It truly means a great deal. Well, that was a big yawn from Arthur there. Big yawn. Just to boost my confidence. I'm nearly done, mate, nearly done. Robert and Yap Yan, thank you for all your effort coming all the way from Holland today to spend the day with us. It's absolutely fantastic, particularly with the way the world is, so thank you.
Where do you get the bill?
It's not even started yet, is it? Two final tips of the hat. Firstly, to all the mums out there, happy Mother's Day. Mum, I haven't got you anything. Julie, I don't think Zara's got you anything. And Zara, don't think Arthur's got you anything. Secondly, to the dads. Well, these two specifically. They've been kind enough to put a few quid behind the bar, so we help the evening get going a little bit. Be nice and quick. Dave's telling me to hurry up. Finally, a toast. And one in keeping with my early days with Zara. I hope everyone's day is well, better than being at work. Cheers. Main event time.
Excellent, Mike. Good work. Got some lights in front of me, which is like being alive at the Apollo. Just threw out the comedy, so don't expect too much. Hiya, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Mike's brother David, and I'm the best man for today. You can probably judge how good a best man I'm going to be and how good a speech this will be by the fact I didn't even make the top table today. Thanks for setting expectations low, Mike. Appreciate it. Thanks to COVID, I've had about 4 years to prepare this speech and still found myself writing it in a panic this week. Firstly, I'd like to start by saying how lovely the bride is looking and what a wonderful day this has been so far. I'd also like to thank the bridesmaids, Marissa, and my sister Nicola, for organising an excellent hen do for Zara, which I know she really enjoyed. And I'd like to thank the lads who attended Mike's stag do in February. Also say a big thanks to Dan Onley, who basically organised and booked the whole thing while I was busy being lazy. So thanks, Dan, it wouldn't have happened without you. Good work, good work. Remember, Paddy, remember, the barman isn't your friend. The barman isn't your friend. So on to the groom, my brother Mike. I turned on him pretty well. I mean, we did share a bedroom and bunk beds until he was 26. I think he got the choice of top or bottom bunk when he's about 6 or 7, and I'm sure the top bunk seemed like a good idea at the time. I'm not sure that it felt like such a good idea in his 20s when he was coming home absolutely wasted and had to finish his night climbing up a ladder into bed. It was a bit of a struggle. I'd help him up sometimes. It was a, come on, we'll get you up there. We'll get you up there. So for this speech, I was trying to think of some funny stories about Mike. I pondered this question for over 4 years and couldn't come up with one. On the stag do in February, I asked some of his friends, do you have any funny stories about my brother? To which they all replied, there aren't any. Great, I thought, this speech is going to be harder than I first thought. So one night I asked my mum and dad for some advice on what to say about my brother about this speech. My dad's advice was not the best. Something along the lines of, you can't be happy all your life, sometime you'll have to get married. That's from experience, I guess. My mum asked what I remember about my brother growing up, and one word comes straight into my mind, mopey. We used to call him Mopey Mike. He didn't enjoy school, he didn't enjoy college, he went to work and become an accountant, and he really didn't enjoy that. We joked, the only time you would see him smile would be down Roots Hall watching Southend United, and that would only happen when they scored a goal or won a match. Anyone who knows anything about football knows that didn't happen very often. But in 2013, something changed in Mopey Mike. He seemed to smile more. More and more, by some miracle, you almost would have called him Happy Mike. Me and my family were racking our brains as to what brought about this change, and then we found out he was dating a girl called Zara. The first time I met Zara was in the summer of 2014. I was heading to Marbella for a lad's holiday, and as a man who didn't own a pair of shorts at the time, I went round my brothers to try on a couple of pairs of his to get an idea of sizes and styles that might look good. Zara was round at the time, and after initial greeting, in which she seemed nice and friendly, I went upstairs to try on the shorts. I looked in the mirror and thought, these look good, I'll get some that look like this. I thought I'd just get a second opinion to make sure I look okay. So I walked into the lounge, and before I could say, how do these look, Zara was already laughing hysterically, looking at me in these shorts. I mean, this was uncontrolled laughter, she was basically crying. Despite Zara being the reason I can never wear shorts again, she quickly became part of the family. It didn't take very long for me to feel like I had another sister in the family, and I'm glad that's finally become official today. Zara, anyone who can make my brother, formerly known as Mopey Mike, as happy as you have, doesn't just deserve a wedding ring, but a medal, trophy, or some sort of statue in your honour. I'd like to congratulate you both for finally tying the knot after a few COVID delays, and wish you both all the happiness for the future. Finally, please join me in raising the glass to toast a happy couple. To Mike and Zara. Cheers. Good.